exerts its effect on the newborn during the second hour after administration. Multiple doses of meprazine causes greater accumulation of both meprazine and nepredine in fetal tissues. Another one is most popular drug is fentanyl. This is fast onset. It has fast onset, short acting synthetic opioid, requires frequent redosing or the use of a patient controlled intravenous infusion pump. So in patient controlled intravenous infusion pump, there is an infusion pump which is handled by patient itself, and it handle it according to need. Fewer neonatal effects and less maternal sedation and nausea. Other opioids are nalbuphine, pentazocine, buprenorphine and butorphanol. Now next is inhalational analgesia, which is given by inhalational agents like halothane, nitrous, etc. These are easy to administer, no needles needed, just mask, put mask on patient's face and connect it to machine, anesthesia machine, and we can deliver it. Nitrous oxide is administered in sub anesthetic concentration, 30 to 50%. It has to mix with oxygen. Analgesia without loss of consciousness. Crosses the placenta but is eliminated efficiently. No untoward neonatal effect. No effects on uterine contractions. Most effective for short term pain relief. Most beneficial in late first stage of labor. Now come to the local and regional techniques, which are most popular techniques. These are local infiltration, pudendal nerve block, paracervical block, paravertebral block, epidural, spinal, combined spinal epidural. These all are regional techniques. Perineal infiltration. Direct infiltration of 1% lignocaine is used for perineal and lower vaginal lacerations. Advance the needle and inject and aspirate to avoid intravascular injection. Intravascular injection should be avoided. Dose of lignocaine is 3 to 4 mg per kg plain solution and 7 to 8 mg per kg with added epinephrine. When we add epinephrine in these solutions, this causes vasoconstriction and increases the effect of these drugs. So this is the use of epinephrine. 1% solution is 10 mg per ml. For 60 kg women, total dose should not exceed 200 mg or 20 ml. After local infiltration, one should wait 3 minutes before proceedings. Another one is paracervical block, which is given in cervix. 5 to 6 ml of diluted solution of local anesthetic without epinephrine, 1% lidocaine or 1 to 2% of 2-chloroprocaine. This is injected into the mucosa of the cervix at the 3 and 9 o'clock positions of cervix. 3 o'clock position and 9 o'clock position for paracervical block. Fetal bradycardia that follows in 2 to 70% of applications. So fetal bradycardia is side effect of paracervical block. Fetal acidosis can occur. Death have been reported. Fetal acidosis and death have been reported. Paracervical block should be used cautiously at all times and should not be used at all in mothers with fetuses in either acute or chronic distress. If fetus is in distress, then it should be avoided. Mechanism of post paracervical block bradycardia. Local anesthetic injected close to the uterine artery passed to the fetus. Uterine artery vasoconstriction secondary to a direct effect of the local anesthetics on the uterine artery. Local anesthetic injected directly into the uterine musculature increases uterine tone. So if local anesthetic injected into uterine artery, it can cause fetal bradycardia. Other is pudendal nerve block. This is minor regional block, effective and very safe. Using a 20 gauge needle, inject 5 to 10 ml of local anesthetic just below the ischial spine. Because the hemorrhoidal nerve may be aberrant in 50% of patients, some prefer to inject a portion of the local anesthetic somewhat posterior to spine. Although a transperineal approach to the ischial spine is possible, most prefer the transvaginal approach. 1% lidocaine or 2% 2-chloroprocaine can be used. Satisfactory for all spontaneous vaginal deliveries and episiotomies, and for some outlet or low operative vaginal deliveries. The potential for local anesthetic toxicity is higher with prodental block compared with perineal infiltration because of large vessels proximal to the injection site. Aspiration before injection is particularly important. So chances of intravascular injection is more in prodental block. Now regional analgesia for labor. In this category, there are epidural anesthesia or analgesia, spinal and CSE. In CSE, combined spinal epidural. What type of anesthesia we give? Fetal neonatal effects of regional analgesia in labor. So advantages are uterine perfusion maintained, profound hypotension and possible fetal compromise. These are the advantages, these are the effects, whether plus, positive or negative. LA toxicity is extremely rare. Fetal heart rate changes, baseline variability is there, periodic deceleration is there. Neurobehavioral effect absent with current agents. Current agents are safer. Epidural analgesia, this is most popular method for labor analgesia, as you all know. Epidural block is the most effective and least depressant, allowing for an alert participating mother. Primary indication is the patient desire for pain relief. Medical indications during labor, selected forms of cardiovascular and respiratory disease. So due to stress of labor, these diseases can be aggravated and harm the patient, so this is medically indicated in cardiac patients and respiratory severe patients, severe problems patients. And prevention or treatment of autonomic hyperreflexia in participants with the high spinal cord lesions. So these are the medical indications. Other is whether patient want to get epidural or not. Epidural analgesia prevents increases in both cortisol and 11-hydroxycorticosteroid levels during labor, but systemically administered topoids do not. So this is the advantage of epidural. It prevents hormonal release. Epidural analgesia also attenuate elevation of epinephrine, norepinephrine and endorphin levels. Now contraindications are coagulopathy, sepsis, patient refusal, fixed cardiac output disease, history of allergy to local anesthetics, thrombocytopenia and hypovolemia. These all are contraindications. Types: lumbar and caudal. Routinely used epidural is lumbar, which is given in lumbar region. Low concentrations of local anesthetics are injected at L2 to L5 level, anywhere between L2 and L5, affecting the small, easily blocked sympathetic nerves that mediate early labor pain, sparing the sensation of pressure and motor function of the perineum and lower extremities. Dose can be adjusted according to patient's response. Choice of drug, local anesthetic drug. Lignocaine can be used, bupivacaine can be used. Lignocaine has rapid onset, it has dense motor block, risk of cumulative toxicity with repeated doses. Bupivacaine has good sensory block, with minimal motor effect, more sensory than motor. No adverse effects on labor with 0.06 to 5% concentration. So with this concentration, patient can walk during labor, and it's known as walking epidural. Due to less concentration of this bupivacaine, motor blockade is not there, so patient can walk. But sensory blockade is there, so pain she cannot feel pain. Bupivacaine is highly protein bound. Fetal blood concentrations are lower than with other local anesthetics. Epidural opioids in labor. We can also inject opioids in epidural space. Commonly we use local anesthetics agent, but opioids can also be used. Inadequate analgesics used alone. If used alone, then analgesia is not proper. Synergistic with local anesthetics. When used with local anesthetics, it provide good analgesia. Speedy onset of analgesia improves quality of analgesia, permits use of very diluted LA solutions, help relieve persistent perineal pain and unblocked segments. So when used with local anesthetic drugs, it decreases the side effects of local anesthetics and improve the block. Fentanyl and sulfentanyl. These agents have rapid onset, few side effects are there. Sulfentanyl slightly more effective, no significant fetal drug accumulation, no serious adverse neonatal effects with either. Side effects of epidural. These are hypotension, local anesthetic toxicity, allergic reaction, higher total spinal anesthesia. If drug goes to spinal, then high spinal may be there. Neurologic injury, spinal headache, fetal bradycardia. These are the side effects. The effect of epidural analgesia on labor progress, fetal position and risk of cesarean delivery is controversial. Randomized studies support the conclusion that epidural analgesia results in a modest prolongation of both the first and second stage of labor. So some studies suggest that it can prolong the second stage of labor. Significant increase in the use of oxytocin for labor augmentation. So these are the negative points of epidural. So prolongation of labor can happen, or use of oxytocin can be more. Increased rate of instrumental delivery, this is also a negative point. Several well-designed randomized studies suggest that in setting with baseline low rates of cesarean delivery, epidural analgesia does not increase the risk of cesarean delivery. Epidural analgesia during labor is associated with an increase in maternal temperature. Dependent on the duration of exposure, mechanism is non-infectious inflammatory activation, changes in thermoregulation, and acquired intrapartum infection. This is a mechanism of increase in maternal temperature. Now, combined spinal epidural. So in this technique, we give drug in spinal subdural space as well as epidural space. Opioids plus minus local anesthetics can be used. Rapid onset of intense analgesia, this is advantage. Ideal in late or rapidly progressive labor. Very low failure rate, less need for supplemental boluses, minimal motor block is there. Walking epidural. Use of opioid only to allow participants to ambulate during labor, because there is little or no interference with motor function. So if we use only opioids, then patient can walk, and so it improves the progression of labor. Early intrathecal opioids followed by continuous epidural infusion in active labor may be a good option for women desiring regional analgesia, offering superior pain control until active labor has been achieved. One randomized study found that use of intrathecal opioid increased speed of cervical dilatation and decreased length of labor when compared with conventional epidural. So this is positive point of intrathecal opioids. The use of intrathecal opioids improve pain control in early labor without increasing the risk of cesarean delivery. Avoids maternal sedation, decreases nausea, vomiting. These all are positive points of intrathecal opioids. Comparisons of intrathecal opioid analgesia versus epidural or parenteral opioids in labor found the use of intrathecal opioids significantly increase the risk of fetal bradycardia. Fetal heart rate should be monitored during and after the administration of either epidural or intrathecal medications to allow for timely intrauterine resuscitation. So fetal heart rate should be monitored. No increase in emergency cesarean delivery. Conclusion. Individualize techniques to patient's goal and stage of labor. Optimize management for spontaneous delivery. Provide safe, cost-effective analysis. So this is a conclusion. Thank you.